Ready to begin our worship. As you noticed when you entered this morning, we're no longer doing registrations for worship. We ask you just to sign in, give contact info. All of our guidelines remain the same. We have to keep our masks on unless we're doing a solo. Natasha can use a break from time if you wish. And readers. And when you're speaking and things like that. And receiving communion, of course. Other than that, we stay put. We come to you for communion. And we'll enter our worship service now. Natasha is going to sing us in our worship time.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Good morning. Wealth in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, our time of worship and celebration. It is certainly good we pause for moments in our daily lives. Remember, our presence is also in God's presence, and he, she is with us. And it is good this morning that we leave our homes and come here to be brothers and sisters together, to hear one another, to support one another, and to encourage one another. As we come together, we also receive God's Spirit, and hopefully recharge our batteries for the days to come. This past week, in the life of our parish, I was actually next door, and just in the community I live in right now, Torbay, and in addition to the things I was doing here, the young man who died in a car accident, 16, was a person I knew very well. The clergy was on holiday, so I spent quite a bit of time and done the service in Torbay at 2 o'clock on Friday. Ask you to remember all the young people that were involved with that situation, but in particular, the torn and weakened family of the young man who died. This afternoon, because of COVID, we have permission now to do baptisms outside of Sunday service. Sometimes families have people with issues and things like that at risk. So there's a Renouf family this afternoon. Twins, we're going to have two young people enter God's family through the sacrament of baptism, and there's more coming up when I am away. Next week, we have our regular worship at 10:30, but there's also a cemetery service, sometimes we nickname it a flower service, next Sunday at 2 o'clock. Hopefully it will be outside. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, you have made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless until they find their rest in you. May we find peace in your service, and in the world to come, see you face to face, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the proclamation of the word.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. Just as he chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world to be holy and blameless before him in love, he destined us for adoption as his children through Jesus Christ, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace that he freely bestowed on us in the Beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses according to the riches of his grace that he has lavished on us. With all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure that he set forth in Christ as a plan for the fullness of time, to gather up all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will. So we, who were the first to set our hopes on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance towards redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm is number 24. The psalm is printed in your bulletin, and the refrain is, "The King of Glory shall come in."
The King of Glory shall come in.
The earth is the Lord's and all that is in it, the world and all who dwell therein. For it is he who founded it upon the seas and made it firm upon the rivers of the deep.
The King of Glory shall come in.
Who can descend the hill of the Lord? And who can stand in his holy place? Those who have clean hands and a pure heart, who have not pledged themselves to falsehood, nor sworn by what is a fraud.
The King of Glory shall come in.
They shall receive a blessing from the Lord and a just reward from the God of their salvation. Such is the generation of those who seek him, of those who seek your face, O God of Jacob.
The King of Glory shall come in.
Lift up your heads, O gates, lift them high, O everlasting doors, and the King of Glory shall come in. Who is the King of Glory? The Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle.
The King of Glory shall come in.
Lift up your heads, O gates, lift them high, O everlasting doors, and the King of Glory shall come in. Who is he, this King of Glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of Glory.
The King of Glory shall come in.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
King Herod heard of it, for Jesus' name had become known. Some were saying, "John the Baptizer has been raised from the dead, and for this reason these powers are at work in him." But others said, "It is Elijah." And others said, "It is a prophet, like one of the prophets of old." But when Herod heard of it, he said, "John, who I beheaded, has been raised." For Herod himself had sent men who arrested John, bound him, and put him in prison, on account of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, because Herod had married her. For John had been telling Herod, "It is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife." And Herodias had a grudge against him and wanted to kill him. But she could not, for Herod feared John, knowing that he was a righteous and holy man, and he protected him. When he heard him, he was greatly perplexed, and yet he liked to listen to him. But an opportunity came when Herod, on his birthday, gave a banquet for his courtiers and officers. and for the leaders of Galilee. When his daughter Herodias came in and danced, she pleased Herod and his guests. And the king said to the girl, "Ask me for whatever you wish, and I will give it." And he solemnly swore to her, "Whatever you ask me, I will give you, even half of my kingdom." She went out and said to her mother, "What should I ask for?" She replied, "The head of John the Baptizer." Immediately she rushed back to the king and requested, "I want you to give me at once the head of John the Baptist on a platter." The king was deeply grieved, yet out of regard for his oaths and for the guests, he did not want to refuse her. Immediately the king sent a soldier of the guard with others to bring John's head. He went and beheaded him in prison, brought his head on a platter, and gave it to the girl. Then the girl gave it to her mother. When his disciples heard about it, they came and took his body and laid it in a tomb. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear God, you stir our hearts within us that we must know you better. And so you bring us, you call us here this morning. We have answered your call. May we open the rooms of our heart now that you may enter in, that you may be present to us in our life at this time, and that we may be present to your world. In your Son's name we pray, Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. You ever see the comedy, the movie, Paul Burt Malka? This guy, the center of the movie, wasn't able or willing to do the things necessary to become a police officer. And so he took a job as mall security. But he makes of it more than what it is. He pretends. Whenever he's faced with a different situation, difficult situation, a situation which calls his attention, he takes a certain stance. If you remember the movie, he puts his hand out in front of him and he turns side on, and he puts his other hand back on his hip to pretend, of course, it's more than what he is. He's got a weapon, he's actually a police officer, and he's somebody to be feared and respected. So in other words, he fakes it. The Gospel this morning, we see a person who fakes it. Herod wants to be called King Herod. And he wants to be much more than what he really is. He wants to have all the power, all the riches, and all the influence of a big king. He wants to be seen for much more than what he is, because Rome really controls the country. He has very little power, but he wants to be seen as the man. And to top it all off, he marries his brother's wife while his brother and his wife are still married. And so John the Baptist, who was roaming the countryside at that point, preaching different things, spoke out against it and said, "That's wrong. You can't marry your brother's wife, she's still married to him. You're a leader of our country, leader in our faith community. It is wrong." And so Herod, not knowing what to do with him, had John arrested and locked him up. But in a strange sort of way, Herod respected John. He was a person of faith. And he also feared the people, because John the Baptist was looked at by some people as a person sent by God, maybe even a prophet. And so he didn't have him killed. Rather, he kept him probably in the palace, whatever form of prison that might have been, and even brings him out every so often to listen to John. But he has a divided heart, because one day he listens to John talking about fate, and Herod is there nodding. He said, that's amazing, that's right, that's good. But then the other part of his heart speaks up. He still wants to be king. He wants the image of the king, the power, the influence, and all that goes with it. And so he fakes it once again and hides John away, take him away, can't do that. And so he has a divided heart. And as a divided heart goes, he was unhappy, he was troubled, and in his case, he was dangerous. Do we have a divided heart? On one hand, we create ourselves. It can be our own desires, our wishes, or based on what other people may see. We create an image that's not entirely true. And on the other hand, we see and hear and know the truth as people of faith. Our conscience and our spirit telling us one thing, but we know what to do, how to live in another way. And so our heart is divided. It's almost like rooms in our heart. We keep them all locked up very tight. In some rooms, it is what we want to show the world. It can be based on anything, our looks, our wealth, our power, influence, popularity, success, honor goals. It can be many different things. And in the other rooms of our heart, which are locked up just as much, we keep our faith, Jesus, God, and we lock it up. A place of truth, where we know how to live, know what to say, what to act, and who to be. We keep that room locked and we don't mingle the two. We don't invite God into those rooms. We want to keep that image, that life, or whatever it is we have created. And so we don't let faith in. We live two lives, a divided heart. And a divided heart quite often is unhappy, it is troubled, and in some cases it can be dangerous. And a divided heart sometimes spills over into our lives. It can affect relationships, school, work, or personality takes a different form. Nothing feels right because nothing is right. But the important thing here is we have a choice. Herod makes his choice. He throws himself a birthday party. And to be the man, he invites all the influential people of the time, puts on this lavish affair. And in the middle of it, his new daughter dances for the group. And her dance must have been something else, because he promises her, because of the dance she's just done, that he's willing to grant a wish, anything at all. Even he's laughing in front of the people, up so much as half his kingdom. She took him up on it. She went to her mom, which was, of course, Herod's brother's wife, and asked, What should I get? There's a marvelous opportunity. And she said, I know what we need. This John is causing us trouble. Maybe Herod would listen to him someday and we'll be out of the palace. And so she said, go ask for the head of John the Baptist on a platter. And so Herod, greatly grieved, even afraid, because of the people, did not kill John, but now he's in front of his guest, being humiliated and shown a sign of weakness. He decided to grant her wish, and so he made his choice. John was beheaded, and his head was delivered to the girl, and the girl delivered it to her mother. We too have a choice. What will we do in life? Will we go on living with a divided heart, or will we make a choice? Usually we don't want to make a choice because we're just too afraid. We're afraid of all the rooms of our heart being introduced to God, to faith, to Jesus. But today we have Jesus who says to us, don't live with a divided heart anymore. Don't live unhappy, troubled. Don't live in fear. Invite me in to every corner, every room of your heart. Place your fear at my feet. Don't base your value on what others say or tell you or how others see you. I will give you value, for you are my brother, you are my sister, and you are unconditionally loved by God, our Father and Mother. You have value, you have importance. And once we have made that choice, we will be freed from fear. Freed from a slavery of what others think to what God thinks. We go from living some things that are fake and masquerade to truth. We go from fear to freedom. And being free is a wonderful feeling. This week, let us work on inviting Jesus into every corner, every room of our heart. Those doors that are locked tight, the dusty corners we don't want him to see. Let us invite him in to all parts. And if we have any fear about the life we know we can live and should live, let us place that fear at his feet so that he may receive it unto himself and free us to be the people we know we are to be. Let us work on having an open heart and not a divided heart. Dear God, we give you thanks this morning because you invite us to invite you into our life and into our heart. May we present fears to you, place them at your feet, and so that we may be free to be the people we know we can be. In your Son's name, in your name we pray, Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. Let us now confess the faith of our baptism as we say, I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our church, that we might be faithful, willing to serve, constant in grace, and receptive to newness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this congregation, that we might be eager to welcome, diligent in prayer, and generous in deed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, town, and neighborhood, that we might be advocates of the lowly, defenders of liberties, and models of justice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who grieve, those in places of care, those in prison, those who are addicted, and those who live in fear and anxiety, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in dangerous occupations, those who care for the sick, those who work the land, those who engage in commerce, those who teach, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who travel, who seek rest, who visit family and friends, who enjoy the gifts of creation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our families and friends and for all placed under our care, for our enemies and for those with whom we disagree, and for those who are examples of grace in our lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank you, God, in Christ Jesus, that you are always more willing to listen than we are to pray. Hear the petitions of this church. Hear the prayers spoken in our hearts. For we pray through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. By what we have done and by what we have left undone, we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Peace of the Lord be always with you. Stand as we pray together. Father, your word creates in us a yearning for your kingdom. Receive all we offer you this day and keep us in your peace. For the sake of Jesus Christ, the Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We give you thanks and praise, Almighty God, dear beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer. Here's your living Word, through whom you have created all things. By the power of the Holy Spirit, who fleshed the Virgin Mary and shared our human nature, he lived and died as one of us to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. In fulfillment of your will, he stretched out his hands in suffering to bring release to those who place their hope in you. And so he won for you a holy people. He chose to bear our griefs and sorrows, and to give up his life on the cross, that he might shatter the chains of evil and death, and banish the darkness of sin and despair. By his resurrection he brings us into the light of your presence. Now with all creation we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious God, accept our praise to your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on the night he was handed over to suffering and death, took bread and gave you thanks, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This is my blood, which is shed for you. When you do this, you do it in memory of me." Remembering therefore his death and resurrection, we offer you this bread and this cup, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. We ask it to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your Holy Church, gather into one all who share in these sacred mysteries, filling them with the Holy Spirit and confirming their faith in the truth, that together we may praise you and give you glory to your servant Jesus Christ. All glory and honor are yours, Father and Son, with the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Church, now and forever. Amen. And now, as the Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I am the bread of life, says the Lord. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever believes in me will never thirst. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Just as I am without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou biddest see come to thee, O Lamb of God, as I am, and waiting not to rid my soul of one dark blot, to thee whose blood can cleanse each spot, O Lamb of God, I come. Just as I am, thou tossed about with many
We may stand as we pray. Living God, in this sacrament we have shared in your eternal kingdom, may we who have tasted this mystery forever serve you in faith, hope, and love. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord. Amen. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the Church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord Jesus, who loves with a wounded heart, be your love forevermore. May the Lord Jesus, who spurs with wounded hands, help you serve others. May the Lord Jesus, who walks on wounded feet, walk with you to the end of the road. Look for the face of the Lord Jesus and everyone you meet, and may everyone you meet see the face of the Lord Jesus in you. In the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Now we're all allowed to sing. Keep on the sunny side.
I thought it might be sunny out this morning. That's why I picked this one, but that's okay.
It's a good try.